Shalom and welcome to Challenging Torah, a project of the Malibu Jewish Center and Synagogue. The challenge? This Torah portion of Vayishlah is about the challenge of our lives. This is about the struggle, the wrestling, the battle between the good inclination and the evil inclination that exists within each one of us. We've dedicated the year to the study of Musar, those qualities that are our tools in the battle against our evil tendencies. But ultimately, it's an inside job. We begin with the story of Jacob 20 years later, and wanting to return home now with 13 children, 4 wives, and a lot of sheep and goats. He comes to the river Jabbok and knows that he cannot go home until he faces his inner demons. He cannot go home until he faces the problem of his brother Esau, who he tricked, robbed of his birthright, tricked him out of a blessing before he ran away. And so he sends the wife and the children, all the wives, all the children, over to the other side of the river, and he remains alone as the sun sets. These battles can only be done alone. This is the moment of wrestling with the truth. And so the Torah tells us, and Jacob was left alone, and there he wrestles with a man until the breaking of day. Jacob was left alone with himself, and he wrestles. And we're not sure, who is this man? On one level, is he an angel? Is he the evil inclination of Esau wrestling with his evil inclination? Is he a projection? Is he God? The more I look at the story, it's all true, but the way we can understand it is this is the moment when he wrestles with himself. Our ultimate battle is with self-realization. And so he wrestles until the breaking of dawn, until the light begins to shine. And when he saw that he had not prevailed against him, he wrenched Jacob's hip at its socket. When he saw he had not prevailed against him, it's not really cool or close. Who's the he? Because there's no ultimate victory here. The story always has a dynamic, not an ending, but there's a wound. And he wrenches his socket and he says, let me go, for day is breaking. I will not let you go, Jacob clearly says, unless you bless me. If life is going to be an endless struggle between the good and the bad, and I get that it's a struggle, please bless me. Let me have a flow from above to below. Help me on this journey. And so he blesses him, and he says, your name shall no longer be called Jacob, but Israel, for you have striven, you have battled, you have wrestled with both God and human beings and have prevailed. It's a wrestling match. Yisrael, the words mean struggled with God. And we are God wrestlers. And we, in our struggles, attempt to see God panim el panim, face to face. We have to engage in the wrestling match with our whole body. It's not enough just to have an idea about God. Turns out, we have to live a life and find God in these dirty details of every decision that we make about what is good and what is evil. And Jacob called the name of the place Peniel, for, as he says, I have seen the face of God and lived to see my life preserved. What is it that we see when we look inside? Do we see the face of God? And we're all wounded. He passed over Penuel as the sun rose upon him, the text says, and he limped upon his thigh. None of us who are God wrestlers get out of here without a wound. That's the way our lives will unfold. And we walk on limping despite the wound. We stay engaged. We continue to wrestle. We battle in each day to make the proper choices. As we engage in our wrestling, our world becomes bigger, and what loomed as an insolvable problem, we can now deal with our brothers, our mothers, our fathers, our sisters, and we reconcile. And so he reunited with his brother Esau, and Jacob said, "Therefore, I have seen your face as though I have seen the face of God," he says to Esau, because in reconciling, he does see the face of God, which is always much larger than the little face that we look at. And at that moment of reconciliation, they go their separate ways, and Jacob came to Shalem, whole, to the city of Shechem. He comes Shalem. He is in a place of wholeness, of stasis, of balance. Would that that were the end of the story. Soon afterwards, Dinah is raped, Rachel dies in childbirth, and he has to swing up yet another rung of the ladder, reminding us of the first dream. There is always a dynamic, always a struggle, always some kind of a wound, and we are able to be Yisrael. Not all the time. Sometimes we're Jacob, a little bit crooked. We strive to see the face of God. We are God wrestlers. May you be blessed in your wrestling. And hopefully you will join us on Shabbat morning as we continue the conversation. Shabbat Shalom and many blessings.